Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. First of all, I want to say thank you so much for all of you who watched my other video. I was so nervous to create it, but I did it. I think in order to create content, it's really difficult and you have to have a lot of motivation and a lot of discipline. And I'm gonna try to have that for my future videos. But I just want to show you who I am and, you know, the real me. And I'm not gonna lose that just because I'm creating content like that's informative at the same time. So you're still gonna get a little, you know, taste of who Layla really is. So this is me. So I just wanted to come here really quickly today and talk about my gear. I'm not gonna bore you with a lot of things because my gear is not, it's really not that many things, but just wanna show you my staple pieces or equipment or gear, whatever you call it. So the first thing obviously is my camera and my lens, and my go-to camera and my only camera, except for the one I'm filming this with, it's my Canon 5D Mark IV and my 100mm f2.8 macro lens. This is what I shoot with like all the time, every single one of my photo shoots. And it's also because it's my only camera, like I said, for photography. I do have other lenses, but this is the one I use when I shoot beauty because it is a macro lens and I can do those really crisp, like close-up photos of lips or like, you know, mascara or something like that. And yeah, this is my camera. And of course you don't have to have this equipment. You can do just about, you can do beauty with just about anything. And I already kind of created a video about that to show you some photos that I took with this gear, which is like probably over $3,000 versus like a $400 camera with a kit lens. And I will show you that another time. For my light, I use my Profoto B10 Plus. I have other Profoto lights as well, like the D1. I have two other ones, but I don't use them anymore because they're just so big and they need cables. But this one is my baby because it's so little and it's, you know, I can take it with me everywhere and I don't have to have cables, people tripping, and it's just the best for me. Of course, you don't need this. You can use whatever light you need as well. And literally you can do beauty photography with natural lighting as well. This is my go-to light for most of my photo shoots. And of course, for every different photo shoot, I use different modifiers, but that will be something that I could use at another, or I could show you at another video. Because I'm working with my Profoto light and my camera, and it's an off-camera flash, I need a remote, and Profoto makes it so that you only have to use this one, I guess at least this light. So I have to have a remote, and this is the remote that I have. And luckily, I didn't have to buy this separately because when I got my D1s, I got this little guy with it. So I always have to remember to bring this with me everywhere. Because I shoot tethered, I have to have a tethered cable, of course. And this is the one I use, is by Tether Tools. And the reason why I have it like this is because I used to shoot with Sony before. And so I bought this so that I could kind of, you know, change it and use whichever, for whatever camera I'm using, which is great. Sometimes it does kind of come off, which is kind of annoying, but that's okay. That is, you know, the reason I didn't want to buy a new one. So if you see this, this is why. But I have to remember to bring this with me everywhere as well, because, you know, when I'm working with a client, we shoot tethered, we can see in the screen everything, right? We can see if there's something in the face or if the makeup needs to be fixed, and then the makeup artist can take care of it. I can see if the photo is focused, etc., etc. So I always have to have this. And of course, a laptop or a monitor or whatever, if you want larger photos, but you need a computer with you and a software. And the type of software that I use is Capture One. You can use Lightroom as well, but I believe Capture One is a little bit faster and it's just what I like better. Of course, for every photo shoot, I will have other gear that I will need, or not even gear, but just things that I will need, like light stands or backdrops, and like I mentioned, different modifiers. But I'm not gonna sit here and show you because that's just kind of a given. Like, and you don't need a backdrop. Sometimes you could use the wall, depends on what you want it to look like, right? Sometimes you're gonna use close-up, so the backdrop doesn't matter. So that was it. I told you this was gonna be really quick. I don't use that many things. And in the future, I will be able to show you how I shoot maybe some BTS videos, and hopefully maybe one day I can create my own class and you can take it with me, or a workshop. But yeah, so if you guys have any questions about gear or what you should use, leave a comment below, and don't forget to like this video. It helps me out a lot. Again, I'm trying to grow, I'm trying to create content, trying to have the discipline to do this for you guys and also for me. So hope you guys like this video. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't yet, and I will see you guys next week. Thank you.